Hey babes, it's Sharonda Isadora, and welcome to Brazen Babe Reviews. And during this video, I'll be talking about a book. That book will be The Wife He Needs by Brenda Jackson. This will I'll add like a picture somewhere in here so that you can see it, because this is ARC that I requested and received through NetGalley. So let's get into this thing, shall we? Okay, so I'll read the blurb to you guys. I'm going to read it from my laptop, from Goodreads, only because this is an ARC. I don't, you know, if I'm not reading it like on my Kindle app or my Nook app or anything like that, so I don't have like quick access to the yes, I accepted, goodness, sorry. to the blurb. So here we go. Will this billionaire bachelor say I do to love? Find out only from New York Times bestselling author Brenda Jackson. He desires her love more than any other woman, but falling in love isn't part of the plan. The arrangement is simple: a two-week getaway, then a marriage of convenience, until Garth Outlaw's potential bride is a no-show. Now family palette Reagan Fairchild is sharing his bed and he can't get enough, even though he's vowed never to love again. Can Reagan convince him the wife he needs and the woman he desires are one in the same? From Harlequin Desire, Luxury Scandal Desire, Welcome to the Lives of the American Elite, Westmoreland Legacy, The Outlaws. This is book one in a new, it's going to be a new series. Now, The Outlaws, I gotta put on my other glasses because these are my regular glasses and I can't really read out of those. Now, this series is a branch off of her Westmoreland series, which is a very extensive series. It's about 30 plus books in her Westmoreland series. Now, Brenda Jackson is an old school black romance author. She has, like I said, her main series, when you look her up, the Westmoreland series is probably going to be that one that pops up, which I said, which is very extensive. So this book is a branch off of the Westmoreland's, and the Outlaws are kind of like kin cousins to the Westmoreland's. And like I said, that's a 30 plus book series and it's huge, which when you go inside of this book, if you do decide to read this book, excuse me, I'm catching a little bit of a something. So, and no, not the Roman. so if I'm coughing throughout the video, just bear with me. What was I going to say? The Outlaws are kind of like kin of the Westmorelands, but throughout this book, you'll hear mentions of the Westmorelands throughout this series. And, you know, if you read that series, you'll probably recognize some names. I think I've probably read like maybe like two or three books in the Westmoreland series. Like I said, it is an extensive series. It's long. When you Google it, you probably, or go on Goodreads, it's probably going to be like 30 plus books you're going to see. And it's like city Westmorelands, it's country Westmoreland. Child's a whole lot of Westmorelands. So this book is a branch off of that. We have the Outlaws, like I said, they're kin to the Westmorelands. In this book is the oldest brother's book, Garth. So in Garth's book, we have Garth, who is excuse me. But Garth is like the oldest brother and this is his book. So we have Garth who wants to get married. He's one of these dudes that in romances, he has sworn off love because his true love, you know, the woman that, you know, he felt that he was gonna love forever. He can't love no more after losing her. You know, she died. They were both in the military and she died and, accident in the military. So Garth has sworn off love. Even though he hasn't sworn off woman, Garth has sworn sworn off love. So at this point in his life, you know, he's working, and, you know, and he's getting this, they had the their dad, their father is like this really grumpy type dude, and he's really on Garth's neck, you know, you need to get married, you need to have kids, so, you know, we can carry on this out, you know, this outlaw name, legacy or whatever, you know, that whole spiel. So, and Garth is kind of like not averse to not doing it. And let's just Sister Charm, which the names of these brothers and sisters in this book, I was like, now Miss Brenda. But anyway, he enlists the help of his sister Charm to help him. They go through this kind of like elite dating agency. Garth has like all the specifics in the world, and he was going to let the person know, like, once they hook up, that this was strictly a business transaction. Yeah, you'll be my wife. Yeah, you know, you're gonna be a rich bitch after you marry me, but don't expect me to love you or anything like that. We ain't here for marriage and a baby. You know what I'm saying? That's Garth. So, but you know, some things go down and the woman doesn't show up. And, like the blurb says, the woman doesn't show up, and he, you know, he's kind of like pissed off, but he's kind of like, boom, whatever, you know, fine, whatever, it is what it is, you know, I don't really care, you know what I mean? So his sister Charm is best friends with Garth's pilot. Reagan Fairchild kind of like grew up with the outlaws because her dad was like the family's pilot for years, and then when her dad retired, she became the family's pilot, but she mainly interacts with Garth. And Reagan has always had this super crush on Garth. Everybody knows she is in love with Garth. Garth, of course, is oblivious. Charm convinces Garth, like, hey, Reagan is in, you know, where you at, visiting, you know, a friend, why don't you just invite her, you know, show her that you appreciate her and invite her, you know, instead of coming back home, wasting this damn trip. Yeah, this lady pulled out. It wasn't really the lady from the agency. It was the agency itself. You know, yeah, the agency fucked up the thing, but, you know, call Reagan and tell Reagan to come to this marvelous chateau in Santa Cruz, and, you know, and y'all relax, you know, you on vacation, like, take a vacation, because Garth is head of the company now that the father is retired, and Garth just work, and, you know, everybody's like, just take a vacation. So Charma's like, you know, call my girl Reagan, you know what I'm saying? She be flying you all around, you know, from cold-ass Alaska, because they live in Alaska, child. So, you know, cold-ass Alaska, like, you know, invite that girl, let her, you know, let her relax, like, dude. So Garth is kind of, like, opposed to it at first, because we come to find out that Garth likes Reagan, and he's kind of, like, fighting it, and his way of fighting it was having this hookup through this agency and marry this strange ass woman. And I'm just like, sir. But anyway. So he's like opposed to it, but eventually he breaks down and he invites Reagan to the marvelous chateau in Santa Cruz. And they are there. And, you know, there's kind of like this, there's this kind of like attraction, tension between them. You know they both like each other, but they aren't really saying anything. And then eventually, you know, Reagan talks to one of her friends. See, Reagan need that kind of friend, because Reagan was just like, you know, that's my boss, yeah, I'm in love with him, blah, blah, blah. And I feel like, girl, you better jump on the dick while you there. You know what I'm saying? Like, why is you not just going, you it's a whole dick there at a marvelous chateau with you. Take advantage of the dick, girl. But Raven's kind of like, no. So her friend was like, well, you know what, girl? I tried. I'm just telling you, it's there. Just take advantage of it while it's there. Garth and Reagan eventually come to this agreement that while they're there for the remaining days, because they had already been there for like a week or whatever. Now, remind y'all, this is a 2-week thing. And they, you know, they decide to take the additional time to have an affair. Now, Garth tells Reagan, you know, the reason why he initially came to the marvelous chateau in Santa Cruz. And Reagan's just like, really, dude? And he's just like, you know, you know, he's explaining to her, like, you know, he's always liked her and all that other stuff. And, you know, no, the other, you know, me inviting you here was not you being a replacement for this woman, this strange-ass woman I was going to ask to marry me. You know, like, girl, it ain't like that. You know, and Reagan's just sitting there like, okay. Mm-hmm. But anyway, so Garth is like, listen, you know, let's have this affair. I just want you to know that I can't love you. Now, when he said that, me and Reagan was like, so he quickly tries to explain that he can never love her because, again, you know, this woman that he met when he was in the service, that was the love of his life, and he just can't love anymore. Yes, he will marry someone. Yes, he will have a child with someone, but he just can't be married. You know, he just can't love you, you know, like that anymore. And initially, Reagan is just kind of like hurt. She's just like, oh my God, you know. But anyway, so you know, she... Reagan agrees to go into the affair because she's initially just like, you know what, let me just see if I can convince him that, you know, there's more than, you know, there's another love out there for him. You know, he doesn't have to deprive himself of never loving anyone else just because, you know, the first love of his life is no longer here. You know what I mean? And, you know, she convinces herself, like, I got these last couple of days. Let me just do this. So, you know, they have this affair. It's all hot and it's all heated. And, you know, they're both kind of like caught up, but they're still both kind of reserved in it. But, you know, Reagan does not leave that chateau a winning woman. They agree to this affair. It kind of like ends on that day, and that's, you know, they go back to Alaska. For this book does, however, end in a happily ever after for now. I'm not going to tell you the deets of the ending, but I'm just going to leave you a little thirst right there. So for the most part, I did like this book. It was an interesting story. I think it kind of like suffered from kind of like the first book in the series. There was, you know, sections of the book, you know, that kind of like, you know, that kind of like meandered along a little bit. And I was just like, okay, you know, I think she, even though she doesn't over explain the connection between the Westmorelands and the Outlaws, you know, so you can, you know, you can get, you know, what's going on there, whatever, you know, I kind of feel like there was some extra stuff and kind of inside of the book that kind of like made the story kind of like meander along. So, you know, we got this dragon a little bit, and, you know, we just wanted it to hurry up. So far as like, you know, romance don't really have like plots or kind of like nuisance kind of like storylines. You know, we have kind of like these hookups, we have a breakup, then sometimes we have like a third act breakup, you know, that kind of like catalyst to get people, you know, to get back together or whatever, so that they can, you know, if it's going to be a happily ever after for now, so that we can have, you know, these people going into, you know, end up being together at the end of this book. So we kind of like have that kind of like formula inside the wife he needs. So I mean, generally with this kind of like this story here, we're just trying to, you know, I think Garth is kind of like, if you read the story, you know, I feel like Garth is going to be an issue for some readers because his kind of like knuckleheadness of not seeing Reagan, you know, right in front of him, you know, and how she feels about him, because I mean, she probably had kind of like the puppy dog looks, you know, like, I love this man look on her face, you know, so him kind of like being resistant to her right in front of his face, I think it's going to annoy a lot of readers, because it annoyed the hell out of me, because I was like, my God, like, and Garth is the oldest, so he's older than Reagan, you know what I mean? So I'm just like, you know, and Reagan's kind of like this, you know, Reagan's kind of like disappointed because Garth reminds her like her father in a sense, because her father was kind of like the same way, you know, he lost his wife and, you know, he never wanted to be with anybody else again. And it was just kind of like, oh my God, like, you just want to stay, you know, by yourself forever because, you know, you feel like you lost the love of your life. And, you know, so I like Reagan, what do you want to call it? She, you know, she had her moments of confrontation with Garth, but she really didn't push him on kind of like, you know, she was just kind of like, all right, well, if that's how you feel, that's how you feel. I'm just going to step back. You know what I mean? Even though everybody around her was kind of like telling her like, yo, you got to let this dude know that, you know, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? So, but I think for this story, Garth is going to get on people's nerves a lot because he was really just like the one in here. It's just like, I can't love nobody no more because I lost the love of my life. And it's like, dude, you got this whole ass woman sitting in your face giving you the good goodies and you up here tripping. So, so I think he's going to work people's nerves a whole lot. So, far as like the characters, this is kind of like, it's a story in character, driven type read. I like the mentions of the Westmorelands inside of the story. You know, we do have like some mentions of why Garth is the way he is, you know, his father. I would really love to get a book on their dad and why he is the way he is, because this man has these kids. He's not what he got baby mamas. Okay. He got baby mamas. He's not with any of them. He never really wanted to be with any of them. This probably was like one of the kids' mamas he wanted to be with, but she was just like, nah, dude, I ain't fucking with you like that. Which kind of made him even more grumpier. So I would love to get a book on the dad and see like why he is and why he's so resistant to being in relations with the Westmorelands. And the Westmorelands is kind of like really like generous with their wealth. So if I found out I'm relatives with a rich motherfucking family and they be like, come on in, we gonna give you some, I'm gonna be like, bitch, I'm like, pack my bag, where's we going, where we going? That would be me. Okay, I mean, even though Garth had, you know, the outlaws had like their own money, but I'm like, if I'm rich and a super rich family come in, like, they gonna be super rich too. But anyway, so I would love to get a book on their dad and, you know, understand why he is the way he is. But anyway, we get a description of why Garth is the way he is, you know, towards, you know, and it just doesn't kind of like come from, you know, him initially losing the first love of his life. It really, you know, it really stems from like his parents' relationship, and not just with them being together, but the way his mother kind of like treated him. And I just don't understand that. Like, people move real funny in the world, and it's just like, and I read that and I was like, you know what, I know there are some women out there like that, that would, yes, I can believe it. Yeah, so Garth is the way he is for reasons, you know, even though he was a bullheaded idiot throughout most of the read. Reagan is a really sweet character. I loved her character. I wish she was a little bit more pushy with Garth. But you know, she did what she could do, and I do like it that she wasn't like fawning over him, like, you know, I'm gonna make you love me, you know what I mean? She wasn't like that, you know what I mean? She tried, she saw that it didn't work, and she was like, fuck it, I'm just gonna go try to be happy on my own, you know what I mean? So they were both likable characters. Garth but really less likable. The writing, I love Brenda Jackson's writing. Even though, like I said, there were some pockets of the story that kind of like meandered along, her writing is really smooth. You know, you can just get into the story without it being, you know, like too much or whatever. She really just like connects everything without overdoing it. So the writing flowed well as well. And I like that. But for the most part, I like The Wifey Needs. I think it's a good book. Like I said, it probably will suffer from, you know, first book in the series type of a thing. But like I said, since it's being a branch off of a really long ass series, you know what I mean? It is what it is, you know what I mean? But it's Brenda fucking Jackson. I mean, like, come on. if you're still feeling free, the book is, I think it comes out on December 15th. So if you're feeling so free, check it out. It's a Harlequin Desire book. It's 218 pages. Real quick read. I liked it. That's all I got. So until the next one, later days.